U.S. President Donald Trump threatens tax on EU cars. U.S. President Donald Trump escalated threats of a trade war, saying he would slap a new tax on European cars if the EU retaliated against his proposed steel and aluminium tariffs, the media reported. Trump on Thursday called for tariffs of 25% on steel imports and 10% on aluminium products, a move he said would bolster those industries domestically, reports CNN. The announcement was met with strong criticism by international trading partners who sigh. Donald Trump says he'll tax European cars if EU pursues Harley-Davidson, Levi's and Bourbon tariffs. Far from backing down, President Donald Trump has escalated transatlantic tensions over trade, saying the United States will simply apply a tax on cars made in Europe if it retaliates against his tariffs on imports of steel and aluminium. The European Union has promised to respond with tariffs on United States exports if Mr. Trump follows through with his plan next week. European Commission President Jean-Claude Juncker promised to go after imports of Harley-Davidson motorbikes, bourbon whiskey, and Levi's jeans. It prompted the US president to respond with threats of more tariffs, if the EU wants to further increase their already massive tariffs and barriers on US companies doing business there. We will simply apply a tax on their cars which freely pour into the U.S. In another tweet he said other countries, laugh at what fools our leaders have been. No more, suggesting he is refusing to yield to U.S. business interests and foreign trading partners alarmed at the prospect of a trade war that rattled financial markets this week. He also criticized Europe in remarks at a fundraiser, according to video posted online on Saturday, and suggested they would not increase tariffs. The European Union, brutal. They've been brutal to us, Mr. Trump said at a Florida fundraiser. Already, Mr. Trump's decision to seek steep tariffs has provoked rarely seen urgency among Republican lawmakers. They are scrambling to convince the president that he would spark a trade war that could stall the economy's recent gains if he does not reverse course. The issue pits Mr. Trump's populist promises to his voters against Republican free trade orthodoxy and the interests of business leaders. Can the U.S. impose a tariff on EU-made cars? Well, the U.S. already imposes a 2.5% tariff on cars assembled in Europe and a 25% tariff on European-built vans and pickup trucks. Europe imposes a 10% tariff on US-built cars. But implementing further tariffs will be complicated given that many European car makers build vehicles at plants in the US, providing thousands of US jobs. For example, German automakers Volkswagen, Daimler AG, and BMW AG build vehicles at plants in the US and BMW employs more than 9,000 workers in South Carolina, making it one of the state's largest employers. Also, as the New York Times reports, the original tariffs were settled after complex international negotiations, suggesting the U.S. might be limited in how it proceeds with the tariffs if it doesn't pull out of the World Trade Organization. Why go after European cars? The U.S. is the largest importer of motor vehicles in the world and the largest market for EU motor vehicle exports. It makes up about 25% of all EU motor vehicle exports and, in 2017, the U.S. had a $22.3 billion automotive vehicle and parts trade deficit with Germany and a $7 billion deficit with the United Kingdom, according to U.S. government data. Mr. Trump has criticized the big trade imbalance, and hopes to address it with higher tariffs. It's also not the first time he has threatened to tax European cars. In January 2017, Mr. Trump warned German car companies he would impose a border tax of 35% on vehicles imported to the U.S. market. Donald Trump is talking himself into a global trade war on Twitter. While officials inside the White House are still shocked at Donald Trump's sudden public pivot toward trade wars with China and the European Union, the president isn't letting up. Instead, he's digging in, taking to Twitter to once again make threats directed at the EU. Our jobs and wealth are being given to other countries that have taken advantage of us for years, Trump tweeted early Saturday afternoon. They laugh at what fools our leaders have been. No more. Meanwhile, officials inside of the Treasury Department are scrambling to contain the fallout from Trump's tweets, which in addition to being wrong, have also frightened investors and outraged U.S. allies across the globe. One senior member of the president's economic advisory team told Politico, "I don't understand what we announced, I don't know what the policy is. Now Trump's White House chaos is rocking the world." Washington, CNN, the chaos and bombast that have driven President Donald Trump's White House into its deepest crisis yet just burst America's borders. Trump's sudden announcement Thursday of punishing tariffs on steel and aluminum imports, after a typically disorganized and opaque rollout, left much of the world feeling the whiplash that has rocked Washington all week. GOP senators blast Trump and No. 39's tariffs announcement. GOP senators blast Trump's tariffs announcement. What's been allowed to go on for decades is disgraceful. It's disgraceful, Trump told reporters, delivering a sudden shock to the global economy by saying he would unveil tariffs next week of 25% on steel and 10% on aluminum. He further stoked fears of world turmoil Friday morning, tweeting that trade wars are good when the U.S. is losing billions in overseas deals. World powers now know what it's been like for Trump's fellow Republicans and staff in a week of turmoil and neck-jerking policy pivots that have left them groping for clarity and trying to work out exactly where the president stands. At home, stocks crashed on the president's offhand announcement, while GOP leaders, stung by a second straight day of Trump trampling party orthodoxy after his surreal meeting Wednesday on guns, registered dissent and frustration. "We were told at the beginning of all this that Donald Trump was comfortable with chaos. That's how he is accustomed to operate," David Axelrod, a former Obama administration top strategist, said on CNN's The Situation Room. "That may be okay if you are running a small family branding business, but when you are in the most important office on the planet it can have grave consequences," Axelrod said. CNN Money, "Some of America's top allies are really, really angry about Trump's tariffs." Given the on-again off-again nature of Thursday's announcement and subsequent lack of details, there was more than a suspicion that the trade move had been fast-tracked to distract from a disastrous week. A feud between Trump and Attorney General Jeff Sessions, the resignation of his confidant Hope Hicks, successive political blows to his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, and signs of multiple lines of inquiry by special counsel Robert Mueller leading deep into the president's inner circle mean Trump has plenty of incentive to try to change the subject. In another blow to a West Wing under siege, CNN reported Thursday that FBI counterintelligence was probing a deal sealed by the president's daughter Ivanka in Canada to see whether it left her vulnerable to foreign agents. White House spokeswoman Sarah Sanders denied the president was trying to divert attention from all that with his trade announcement, saying it was hardly news that Trump thinks global commerce, particularly as practiced by nations like China, cheats American workers. "The president is concerned about the men and women of this country who have been forgotten about, the industries that our country was founded and built on. And this shouldn't come as a surprise to anybody," she said. Trump escalates trade war rhetoric with threat to tax Europe-made cars. Donald Trump has escalated the threat of a trade war with Europe, warning that the U.S. will slap a tax on cars made on the continent if the European Union, EU, retaliates against tariffs on imports of steel and aluminium. Trump trade tariffs, Europe threatens U.S. bikes, bourbon, and blue jeans. Read more. The American president made a surprise announcement this week that he intends to impose a 25% tariff on steel and 10% on aluminium in an attempt to protect U.S. industry. The European Commission president, Jean-Claude Juncker, said the bloc was prepared to respond forcefully by targeting U.S. imports such as Harley-Davidson motorbikes, Levi's jeans, and Kentucky bourbon whiskey. On Saturday, Trump hit back in typical style, writing on Twitter, "If the EU wants to further increase their already massive tariffs and barriers on U.S. companies doing business there, we will simply apply a tax on their cars which freely pour into the U.S. They make it impossible for our cars, and more, to sell there. Big trade imbalance." In another tweet, the president railed against very stupid trade deals by earlier administrations and said other countries laugh at what fools our leaders have been. No more. Trump has previously attacked car manufacturers in Europe, especially in Germany, with which the U.S. has a huge trade deficit. Last year, in an interview with the German newspaper Bild, he criticized companies such as BMW, Daimler, and Volkswagen for failing to produce more cars on U.S. soil and threatened a border tax of 35% on vehicles imported to the U.S. market. A few months later, at a closed-door meeting with EU officials in Brussels, he was quoted by Der Spiegel as saying, "The Germans are bad, very bad. Look at the millions of cars that they sell in the U.S. Terrible. We're going to stop that." BMW, Daimler, and Volkswagen operate some of their biggest factories in southern, Republican-leaning U.S. states. German car makers employ about 33,000 workers in the U.S. and German automotive suppliers about 77,000 more, according to Germany's Automotive Industry Association. Cassette Kremer, an assistant professor of political science and trade expert at the University of Minnesota, noted that Trump's proposals remain vague. The administration has not indicated which types of steel and aluminium the proposed tariffs will cover, or whether there will be any exemptions or carve-outs for certain types of steel/aluminium imports or for certain countries, she wrote in an email on Saturday. All that being said, engaging in escalatory trade war rhetoric even, and particularly, if you don't end up following through is damaging for our diplomatic relations with our allies. Moreover, taxes on cars made in Europe won't impact European firms much since many of these companies assemble or manufacture their cars either in the US or Mexico. Kremer added, "It seems to me that if these tariffs are imposed across the board, the detrimental impact on Europe will come not so much from the direct tariffs on steel imported from EU countries, which is actually a small fraction of our steel imports. Rather, it will come from the destabilizing effects on the European market caused by the flooding of steel from countries that would have otherwise exported to the US." Trump campaigned on an America First agenda of economic nationalism, promising to bring jobs back. But his latest move was, according to NBC News, a knee-jerk reaction born of anger during at the White House. He followed up with a tweet that said trade wars were easy to win, rattling US financial markets. The plan breaks from Republican orthodoxy on free trade and has left members of Congress scrambling. They warned that a trade war would hurt U.S. companies and wipe out recent economic gains. Canada has said it will retaliate for any tariffs on steel and aluminium. Ex-Trump advisor sold $31 million in shares days before president announced steel tariffs. Read more. The Arizona Senator John McCain tweeted, "The president's sweeping tariffs will only serve to hurt American workers and consumers, and alienate us from our most important allies and trading partners." Michael Steele, former chairman of the Republican National Committee, said, "Our allies are sitting and going, what the hell is your problem?" On Friday, the Swedish appliance maker Electrolux said plans for a plant expansion in Springfield, Tennessee had been put on hold because of Trump's announcement. Unfortunately, this decision gives foreign appliance manufacturers a cost advantage that is hard to compete against, spokeswoman Eloise Hale said in a statement to the Tennessean newspaper. There was also a chorus of media criticism. Rupert Murdoch's Wall Street Journal, normally supportive of the president, commented, "Protectionism may be his only real policy conviction, and his tweet confirms he doesn't know what he's talking about." The White House announced on Friday that Trump had held calls with the German Chancellor, Angela Merkel, and French President, Emmanuel Macron. The leaders discussed Syria and Russia, according to an official statement that made no mention of trade. "Since you're here, we have a small favor to ask. More people are reading The Guardian than ever, but advertising revenues across the media are falling fast. And unlike many news organizations, we haven't put up a paywall. We want to keep our journalism as open as we can. So you can see why we need to ask for your help." The Guardian's independent, investigative journalism takes a lot of time, money, and hard work to produce. "But we do it because we believe our perspective matters, because it might well be your perspective, too." Trump steps up war of words on trade with threat to tax EU cars. U.S. President Donald Trump has stepped up his war of words over trade tariffs, threatening to apply a tax on imports of cars from the European Union. Mr. Trump said other countries had taken advantage of the U.S. for years because of its very stupid trade deals. The trade wrangle began on Thursday when Mr. Trump vowed to impose hefty tariffs on steel and aluminium imports. That brought a stiff response from trading partners and criticism from the IMF and WTO. EU trade chiefs have reportedly been considering slapping 25% tariffs on around $3.5 billion, £2.5 billion, of imports from the U.S., following Mr. Trump's proposal of a 25% tariff on imported steel and 10% on aluminium. They would target iconic U.S. exports including Levi's jeans, Harley-Davidson motorbikes, and bourbon whiskey, European Commission head Jean-Claude Juncker said. Five reasons why trade wars aren't easy to win. Steel tariffs, what impact will they really have? What has Mr. Trump said now? In a tweet on Saturday, the president said, if the EU wants to further increase their already massive tariffs and barriers on US companies doing business there, we will simply apply a tax on their cars which freely pour into the US. They make it impossible for our cars, and more, to sell there. Big trade imbalance. A second tweet decried the $800 billion yearly trade deficit because of our very stupid trade deals and policies. Mr. Trump added, our jobs and wealth are being given to other countries that have taken advantage of us for years. They laugh at what fools our leaders have been. No more. How many EU-made cars go to the US? The US is the largest export market for EU cars, making up 25% of the €192 billion, £171 billion, $237 billion, worth of motor vehicles the bloc exported in 2016, China was second with 16%. Germany is responsible for just over half of the EU's car exports, so new US tariffs would hurt the car industry there. But German carmakers also build hundreds of thousands of cars in the US every year, providing many U.S. jobs that German officials say Mr. Trump overlooks. Do fellow Republicans back Mr. Trump's trade threats? A number have questioned the wisdom of the tariff proposal and have been urging the president to reconsider. Senator Orrin Hatch said, I'm very surprised, he's had very bad advice from somebody down there. The people who are going to have to pay these tariffs are going to be the American citizens. Senator Ben Sasse said, kooky 18th century protectionism will jack up prices on American families, and will prompt retaliation. And industry bodies like the U.S. Motor and Equipment Manufacturers Association have expressed deep concern, saying the benefits from the recent cuts in corporation tax could all be for naught. But Mr. Trump's Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross stood firmly behind the plans, saying the president was fed up with the continued overcapacity. He's fed up with the subsidization of exports to us. Why does he want to impose tariffs? It chimes with his America First policy and the narrative that the US is getting a raw deal in its trade relations with other countries. Mr. Trump tweeted on Friday that the US was losing billions of dollars and would find a trade war easy to win. The president is using a clause in international trade rules which allows for tariffs for national security reasons. But his move has not come totally out of the blue. The Commerce Department recommended tariffs in February after conducting a review under rarely invoked national security regulations contained in a 1962 trade law. Mr. Trump had already announced tariffs on solar panels and washing machines in January. What has the international response been? The IMF said others could follow the US leader's precedent by claiming tough trade restrictions were needed to defend national security. Donald Trump praises China's decision to scrap limit on presidency term. US President Donald Trump praised his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping on Saturday after the ruling Communist Party announced it was eliminating the two-term limit for the presidency, paving the way for Mr. Xi to serve indefinitely. He's now president for life, president for life. And he's great, Mr. Trump said, according to audio of excerpts of Trump's remarks at a closed-door fundraiser in Florida aired by CNN. And look, he was able to do that. I think it's great. Maybe we'll have to give that a shot someday, Mr. Trump said to cheers and applause from supporters. U.S. presidents by tradition served a maximum of 2 4-year terms until President Franklin Roosevelt was elected a record 4 times starting in 1932. An amendment to the U.S. Constitution approved in 1951 limits presidents to 2 terms in office. China's annual parliament gathering kicks off on Monday as Mr. Xi presses ahead with efforts to ward off financial risks without undermining the economy. The Communist Party announced on February 25 the end of the 2-term limit for the president, and the parliament is expected to ratify the move. During the remarks, Mr. Trump praised Mr. Xi as a great gentleman and added, "He's the most powerful Chinese president in 100 years. Mr. Trump said Mr. Xi had treated him tremendously well during his visit in November. The White House did not immediately respond to a request for comment late Saturday. Mr. Trump has often praised Mr. Xi, but in January Mr. Trump said the United States was considering a big fine as part of a probe into China's alleged theft of intellectual property. He has been critical of China's trade policies. Mr. Trump told the New York Times in December that because of North Korea he had been soft on China, because the only thing more important to me than trade is war. Maybe we'll give that a shot." Donald Trump praises Xi Jinping's power grab. U.S. president says it is great that the Chinese premier has paved the way to become president for life. Donald Trump has celebrated Xi Jinping's bid to shepherd China back into an era of one-man dictatorship, suggesting the United States might one day give that a shot. China's authoritarian leader took power in 2012 and had been expected to rule until 2023. However, last week it emerged that Xi would attempt to use an annual meeting of China's parliament, which kicks off on Monday morning, to abolish presidential term limits by changing the Chinese constitution. Liberals have condemned the power grab, which will almost certainly be approved by members of the National People's Congress who have flocked to Beijing for the 2-week summit. Experts say the amendment paves the way for Xi to be China's ruler for life. "This is a critical moment in China's history," Cheng Li, a prominent expert in elite Chinese politics who has criticized the move, told AP. However, Trump offered a more positive assessment during a fundraising event at his Mar-a-Lago estate, where he hosted Xi last April. "He's now president for life. President for life. And he's great," the U.S. president reportedly told Republican donors. "And look, he was able to do that. I think it's great. Maybe we'll give that a shot someday," Trump added, according to CNN, which obtained a recording of what it described as an upbeat, joke-filled speech. Even before Trump's controversial remarks, Chinese activists and dissidents had voiced disappointment over the lack of criticism from Western governments and leaders. "This kind of reaction is very short-sighted," said Zhou Fengxuo, a democracy activist who has lived in exile since fleeing the 1989 Tiananmen crackdown. 8 signs that Xi Jinping was planning to cement his grip on China. Read more. "This kind of permanent leadership never ends well. History tells us it will not just be a Chinese issue, it will have a deep and profound influence on the world. China will see a lot of uncertainty and likely conflict because of this." The topic of Xi's power grab is so politically sensitive within China that nearly all of the academics approached by The Guardian for comment in the lead-up to Monday's Congress declined to talk. Xinhua, the only Chinese scholar who agreed to be interviewed, claimed foreign journalists were over-interpreting and over-emphasizing the move. "I hope Western media can view this proposal in a comprehensive and objective manner," said Xing, from the China Institute of International Studies, a state-run think tank. However, Western experts say they are convinced Xi's plan is to rule for many years to come. "He's now 64. So he has got at least 20 years left in him. That would take him almost to the centenary of the establishment of the People's Republic in 2049, said Roderick Mac Farquhar, a Harvard University China expert. Mac Farquhar said China's supreme ruler was seeking to change China's constitution rather than simply ignoring it, so as to avoid looking like some sort of banana republic. But the effect was the same. He's signaling, "I'm going to stay on forever." "Dictators are always arrogant," said Qiao Miu, a journalism professor who moved into exile in response to Xi's reign. "It's a disaster for political civilization. Donald Trump praises Xi Jinping for his grip on power in China. After news of Chinese President Xi Jinping possibly ruling his country into the indefinite future, a transcript has surfaced of Donald Trump saying he might do the same. In closed-door remarks, a recording of which was obtained by CNN, Trump congratulated Xi for consolidating power, adding he wouldn't mind making such a move himself. He's now president for life. President for life. And he's great, Trump said. And look, he was able to do that. I think it's great. Maybe we'll give that a shot someday. China's ruling Communist Party last month proposed removing a two-term limit on presidential terms, a suggestion almost sure to be adopted by the country's rubber-stamp parliament during its annual session starting March 5. In the closed-door meeting from yesterday, Trump also complained about Hillary Clinton not being investigated after the 2016 presidential election, making claims it is a rigged system that still doesn't have the right people in place to fix it, during a freewheeling speech to Republican donors in Florida on Saturday. I'm telling you, it's a rigged system, folks, Trump said. I've been saying that for a long time. It's a rigged system. And we don't have the right people in there yet. We have a lot of great people, but certain things, we don't have the right people. Trump has openly attacked his attorney general, Jeff Sessions, on Twitter for not taking what he views as necessary steps to investigate Clinton's actions involving her private email server. Trump, maybe US will have a president for life someday. Washington President Donald Trump says he thinks it's great that China's president now holds that office for life and muses that maybe the US will do the same someday. Trump's remarks came during a luncheon for Republican donors Saturday at his South Florida estate. CNN reported the remarks based on a recording it obtained. Chinese President Xi Jinping recently consolidated power. Trump told the gathering, he's now president for life. President for life. And he's great. Trump added, I think it's great. Maybe we'll give that a shot someday. Trump criticized his Democratic presidential opponent Hillary Clinton, repeated his view about a rigged system, and called the invasion of Iraq the single worst decision ever made. He referred to former President George W. Bush as another real genius.